When I first heard the term medical home, I didn't really know what that meant. I thought maybe it was a house. But a medical home is not a house. It's not a doctor's office. It's not a hospital or a dentist office. It's basically a partnership. It's an approach. So it's more of an idea than it is an actual thing. It's a partnership between you as the parent or the caregiver and your the practice, as far as it's not just the doctor, because the doctor is a really important relationship for you, but it's also the doctor's staff, whether that's the receptionist who's answering the phone and checking you in and taking your insurance information, or maybe the nurse who is doing the initial intake. It's a relationship that you have with all of the people in that practice. And it's really important that you think about that relationship, because it's important that you pay attention to not only are they qualified, is it a good doctor, is it a good practice, but also think about how they make you feel. Do they make you feel comfortable? Do they make you feel cared for? Pay attention to the way that you feel, because that's really important. As the parent, sometimes I've been intimidated going into doctor's offices, because I think, okay, this doctor, he went to medical school, and I didn't go to medical school, so what do I know? He's the professional, and he knows it all, right? Well, the reality is, we, as the parents, spend day-to-day, in and out, the down and dirty, with the kids 24 hours a day. And so we're the experts on our children. And so it's important, and sometimes that's hard to buy into, but it's true. You know your child better than any of the doctors or the nurses. And it's important that you believe that. And to have a successful medical home, you need a doctor who values that and who respects you as a valuable partner. Because, you know, you think about what a partnership is, and a partnership is when both people bring something to the table. It's not one-sided. And so it's important that you have a doctor and a practice that value what you bring to the table, which is a huge amount of knowledge of your child. And sometimes you have to think about the intimidation factor that you feel when you go into the doctor's office. And whenever I go into a doctor's office, one thing that I do that I have found that really helps is I take notes. Before I go to the doctor, I think about, okay, what are my questions? What are my concerns? What are the things that I really need to cover with this doctor? And because when I don't take my notes in there, I go in there, he asks me a few questions, I might ask a question, and then I totally forget what some really important things. And it's not until 11 o'clock at night when I'm laying in the bed that I think, man, I can't believe I didn't ask something very important. So if you go in there prepared, you go in there with your notes, you can go in there and just check them off the list. This one, this one, this one. And so that's one way that you can make your medical home successful.